Good day, students. In this clip, we're going to be going over some examples reviewing the properties of logarithms. Before we get started, let's take a look at some example, the properties first of all. Remember the product property? We have, if we have log of x, y is the same thing as log of x plus log of y. Okay, and then for the quotient property, log of x over y is equal to log of the numerator minus log of the denominator. Okay, and we have the power property. We have log of x to the a, same thing as you can power down the exponent of the logarithmic argument, log of x. Okay, now let's take a look at the first example. The first example says which expression is equivalent to log 16 base 4 plus log 6 base 4 minus log 8 base 4. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to condense this logarithmic expression. So here we have a product, we have a sum. Using the product property, this can be converted into a product, and this minus can be converted into a quotient. Okay, so we can rewrite this as log base 4 of 16 times 6 divided by 8. Okay, so we see the plus becomes a times, the minus becomes a division. Okay, let's see if we can reduce this term right here. Let's reduce it. 2 goes here. Let's see, actually, we can reduce this by 8. 8 goes here 1. 8 goes here 2. And then just multiply the numerators. That yields log base 4. 6 times 2 is 12. All right. And then our final answer is clearly option letter A. All right. Let's take a look at the second example. It says if log base 2, if log of 2 is approximately 0.301 and log of 3 is 0.477, then what is the approximate value of log 18? So the question here is, can I express 18 using 2 and 3? So if we we think about it, we can express 18 as 18 can be written as 2 times 3, which is 6 times 3. Okay, so now we're gonna write log 18 is equal to log of 2 times 3 times 3. 2 times 3 times 3. Now we're going to use the product property of logarithms to expand this. Okay, so if we apply that here, we have log of 2 plus log of 3 plus log of 3. All right, now we're going to input the approximate values of each log expression. So this is approximately going to be 0.301, let's line it up vertically, plus 0.477, and then plus 0.477, okay? 0, 0, 0. All right, let's add it downwards. So we are going to have 7 plus 7 is 14 plus 1, that's 15, 5 carry 1. 15 again, 5 carry 1. We have 4 plus 4 plus 4, that's 12, 2 carry 1, 1.255. So we see that our answer is option letter A. All right, let's shift our attention to the third question. So for the third one, we have we need to condense using the properties of logarithm. So we're going to be going backwards in this example. Okay, so here we have the sum, which can be expressed as a product, and then we also have the minus or difference, which can be expressed as a quotient. Okay, so if we apply the properties of logarithms here, we have log base 5 of 3 plus. Now this 4 in front, we can use the quotient, the power property, to power that 4 up, and then express that term as log base 5 of x to the 4th power minus log base 5 of x plus 2. All right, now let's go ahead and condense this expression. We're going to have in the numerator log base 5 of 3 times x to the 4th divided by in the denominator x plus 2. Okay, so that's basically what our final answer is. Log base 5 of 3x to the 4th divided by x plus 2. All right, and our final answer is option letter D. All right, let's take a look at the last example. So for this one, we are to solve this equation, 9 to the 8th n minus 11 equals 1 over 6,561. So to do this, the question is, can we express this fraction on the right as a power of 9? Okay, so what we can do is basically go through the powers of 9 using our calculator, or you can do it by hand. So 9 to the first power, we know is 9. We know that 9 to the second power is 81. 9 to the third power is 729. And see, 9 to the 4th power, 6,561. That's exactly what we want. So we're going to make a substitution here. 9 to the 8 n minus 11 equals 1 over 9 to the 4th. It's not complete yet. We want to express this as a power, as 9 to a power, but this is a fraction. So what we're going to do is you're going to use the reciprocal property of exponents to express the right side as 9 to the negative 4. Okay, now we can just cancel out the bases since they're identical, or we can just take log base 9 of 9 to the 8 n minus 11 and then log base 9 of 9 to the negative 4. Okay, using the inverse property of logarithms, this cancel out and then these cancel out. You'll be left with split up our workspace right here. We'll be left with 8n minus 11 equals negative 4. All right, and let's get n isolated. We'll add 11 to both sides. We have 8n equals positive 7. And then divide both sides by 8. And then you have n equals 7 over 8. So our final answer is option letter C. Okay? So that's that.